Hi, thanks for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to talk about the different components of the cholesterol blood, the blood work. Often you'll have blood work done by your doctor and perhaps he's given you the results and you're a little bit confused as to what they actually mean. So we're going to walk through this. Okay, I'm going to talk through the standard cholesterol panel. On the left-hand side, you've got the standard components that you see in a cholesterol panel: total cholesterol, triglycerides, HDL cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, which can be both calculated and direct, the cholesterol to HDL ratio, and then the level of non-HDL cholesterol. And then in the two other columns, you've got the units. And more commonly in Europe, you might see millimoles per liter. And then in America, you'll often see milligrams per deciliter. And what this means is so if you look at total cholesterol, this is the total amount of cholesterol in the sample of blood that you've given, in all the lipoproteins within that sample. So it's the total amount of cholesterol in your HDLs, your LDLs, your VLDLs. And so they've measured that, and then they've normalized it to the sample volume. And that's where the per liter or per deciliter comes in. Now, total cholesterol was one of the first measurements of cholesterol that was used. We don't tend to use it now. It's a very rough measurement. Actually, we're more interested in things like ApoB and LDL particle count and LDL cholesterol when it comes to looking at risk, but it's still presented in the lipid panel. And then you've got triglycerides, and the number that you get is the total amount of triglycerides in all the lipoproteins within your sample. And triglycerides tend to be carried in two main particles. If you're fasting, they're mainly found within the VLDL, or very low density lipoproteins. If the sample's non-fasting, then you may well have eaten some food that could have been packaged up into chylomicrons, and the triglycerides might be elevated because you've got a lot of chylomicrons in the blood. So we often, if you're interested in looking at triglycerides, we make sure the patient's fasted beforehand. And if you've got high triglycerides, you've got to make sure that it was actually done on a fasting sample. Then HDL cholesterol is the total amount of cholesterol found within the high density lipoprotein particles. And similarly, the LDL cholesterol is the total amount of cholesterol found within the LDL cholesterol particles. Now, interestingly, out of all the components, the LDL one is often just calculated and not actually directly measured. And there's an equation called the Friedewald equation, which basically calculates LDL based on the HDL and total cholesterol and triglyceride levels. So you can often have a spurious LDL cholesterol number if your triglyceride level is high. So you should always push your doctor to do a direct LDL measurement and that basically means that the cholesterol has been directly measured within the LDL cholesterol particles. You're often presented with a ratio of total cholesterol to HDL, and the lower this is, the lower your risk. But we don't tend to look at that so much anymore as a risk stratifier. And then a good measurement is non-HDL cholesterol. And that's basically the total amount of cholesterol in all the particles that aren't high density lipoproteins. And that's actually a reasonably good measure of risk and often correlates with the ApoB count. And then in more advanced panels, you might see an ApoB number or an LDLP. Now, LDLP is the LDL particle number. And if you have a test done called nuclear magnetic resonance, it's a very detailed lipid study, which looks at the total number of particles plus the size of those particles. Because if you look over here to the right-hand side, these are, if I just bring up my little pointer, these are both LDL particles, but you can see they're very different sizes. And it's thought that the smaller the LDL particle, the more likely it is to end up in the artery wall, get oxidized, and lead to atherosclerosis. So often your LDLP will be found in your NMR report, and they will look at the size of your particles. The bigger your particles, the less risk of cardiovascular disease. But this is a relatively expensive test. It's not commonly done, and you won't find it on a standard lipid panel. But ApoB is far much easier to find, it's much cheaper, and it's an excellent surrogate for particle number. And the reason being is that this, on every single LDL particle, you have an apolipoprotein B molecule, and there's one molecule per particle. So the ApoB number you get is a surrogate for the number of particles. And the risk of cardiovascular disease is driven both by the particle size and the number or concentration of particles you've got in your bloodstream. So if you have a very high ApoB number, suggests you've got a very high particle count, and that puts your risk of cardiovascular disease much higher. If you have any questions, please drop them down in the comments below. Thanks.